pain of Michael's passing is with his brother Jermaine every day. It was not easy for him to return to Forest Lawn for our interview, and it's not easy for him to talk about the circumstances surrounding the death. But he does. Do you think your brother was killed?
Yes, of course. Of course.
No doubt in your mind?
No doubt in my mind.
Have the authorities done enough? They haven't done, well, they've stopped at Murray, haven't they?
Yeah, but when you looked at the authorities, they've done their part, but at the same time, it's the DA's office, and I just don't trust anybody. I really, really don't. Mm. We lost a brother. What really has really, one of the hearings we went to, they're sitting in there laughing, Larry. They're laughing. I felt like getting up and walking out.
Ooh, the
first of all, I think TMZ was filming this, and they're all showboating for the camera, and they were talking about whether the license should be taken or not, and there's chuckles and laughs, and I'm sitting there saying, we lost our brother. How disrespectful. And we're sitting there, and I wanted to get up so bad and just walk out. This is our system, our judicial system, and they're sitting there laughing. And
does the family plan any civil action?
Well, we're in meetings, and that's a good question. But right now, we're just trying to make sure that every rock is turned over, and we can really get a thorough investigation.
Do you think we'll ever find out the whole story?
Yes, yes. You know why? Because his family is not going to let it not happen. We love him. We miss him. The world needs to know the truth. We need to know the truth. You need to know the truth. And absolutely, we're going to do everything in our power as a family to make sure the world knows what really happened.
Has the estate paid the city, by the way, to cover the public memorial at Staples?
Yes.
No stories about that. What is this?
Larry, it's... Michael's estate is probably one of the most successful financial estates. Close to $1 billion now, up to this day. And to have all these things about debt and this and that, it's like when he was alive, they beat him down with this child molestation stuff to try to make it seem like he did this, because you beat someone down with the very thing that they love. And this was all planned. This was all to try to kill him with that. They couldn't kill him with that. So he had a dependency on sleeping pills or whatever. So they found a way to kill him with that. They found a way.
But the city's been paid. All that is cleared. The day Michael died, how did you find out? I remember you told me, but...
I found out...
Where were you?
I was in Azusa, not too far, on the other side of Pasadena. Someone from your office called my wife's phone and
CNN said, told you?
Yes, you guys told us first. And they said, do you know anything about Michael being rushed to the hospital? So I said, no. And then I got off with them and I called my mother right away. And my mother said, yes, I'm on my way to the hospital right now. So once I got off with her, 45 minutes had gone by, I spoken to an attorney friend Joel Katz, and then I spoke to my sister Janet. And then Joel had mentioned to me saying it was pretty bad. And I was saying, wow. And then I called my mother back, and she was there in the hospital. And I heard her say, he's dead. He's dead. He's gone. The tone of her voice, Larry, was a tone that I've never heard before. And I cried. I didn't know how to get from Westwood from Azusa, so we put it in the navigation, and we're crying along the way, and our phone is ringing off the hook, and people texting and calling, and I'm hearing that the whole phone system crashes. And as we got closer to Westwood, we see all these helicopters. Yeah, we see all these helicopters hovering in the sky, and Westwood is, people are standing and still, and it's taped off. And so I drive up to the policeman, and they let me in, and I go to the emergency part, and I go straight to my mother, and she's sitting there like in a daze, like she was just in a daze, numb, staring into space. And then I said, I consoled her a bit, and then I went to see him. I said, well, where is he? And they say he's down the hall a bit. And I walked in this room, and it took a lot, Larry, to walk in the room and see your brother laying there lifeless, laying on the this gurney thing, like, and I sort of touched his face, and he was still soft. He was still soft, and I pulled his eyelid back to look at his eyes, and I just kissed his face, and it's a horrible feeling to have death in your family that close.
Where were you when Michael Jackson died? Tell us. Go to Facebook.com/CNN Larry King Live and let us know. Jermaine sang Michael's favorite song at his brother's memorial service. We'll go back to that day right after this.